Good morning, children. I hope you all are taking good care of yourself and staying at home. You must have gone through the previous presentation. Now I am going to continue the presentation with the components of food that I have given in the previous presentation. Now we'll go through it one by one. First component of food is carbohydrates. Carbohydrates is a rich energy giving food that gives us energy to work, study, play and do all other daily chores. Now you must be seeing the pictures below. These are the sources of carbohydrates from which we eat every day. For example, sugar, rice, wheat flour, maize and barley. If we include any of these things in our food daily, we are getting carbohydrates. In daily food diet, we all must be having chapatis and rice and potatoes. That are also good sources of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates, as we know, are energy giving food that is required by the people, those who are doing much of hard work, like laborers, farmers, rickshaw pullers, and even those who are doing lots and lots of sports activities. Right? Now we move on. Fats. Fats are also known as energy giving foods, but as compared to carbohydrates, fats gives us more energy. The sources of fats are vegetable oil, ghee, butter, cheese, nuts and cream. Greens we eat in the form of pastries and cake. When we are consuming fat, only less amount of energy is utilized by our body for our daily activities, and the extra fat is stored in our body. And if we go on consuming more and more fat on a daily basis, then it makes us obese. That's why it is suggested to eat low fat food. Right? Now we move on to a chart that shows various nutrients that we are requiring from our daily food and what are the sources. Here the first is iron. Iron, we know, it is very important for making us healthy and to maintain hemoglobin level in our blood. The sources of iron are green leafy vegetables, fruits and cereals. Calcium. Calcium, your mama must be telling you to have a glass of milk twice in a day, morning and evening or at night. Why she is asking you to drink milk? Because milk is a very good source of calcium. And can you tell me why we are requiring calcium? Yes, calcium is required for healthy bones and teeth. And what are the other sources of calcium? Almonds, soya milk, egg and turnip. Now next is vitamins. Vitamins, the common vitamins that is required by our body are vitamin A, B, C and D. And the sources of vitamins are different vegetables, fruits, meat, egg and soya products. Proteins and fats are also there. Fats we have already discussed. Proteins are also known as protective or bodybuilding foods because they help us to grow strong. Now, proteins. Proteins are bodybuilding food. Why they are called bodybuilding food? Because they help us to grow and keep ourselves healthy. That is why we say the growing children need more proteins as compared to the adults. The common sources of proteins are milk, paneer, cheese, pulses and cereals. And those who are non-vegetarians, they can have eggs and meat also as a good source of protein. Next is vitamins. Vitamins are food that are known as protective food. Why they are called protective food? Because they help us fit and healthy and they help our body fight against different diseases. The common vitamins required by our body are A, B, C and D. And the sources of vitamins from which we get vitamin supply for our body are green leafy vegetables, fruits, whole grains and milk and milk products. See, here is a chart shown that what are the different sources of vitamin A, B, C and D. For vitamin A, you can see curd, cheese, carrot, bell pepper, broccoli and pumpkin. For vitamin B, bread, peas, meat, loaf, whole grain are the sources of vitamin B. Vitamin C, green leafy vegetables, citrus, kiwi and bell pepper. And for vitamin D, egg, fish, milk and meat are the good sources of vitamin. Now minerals. Minerals are something that is required by our body in a very less quantity, but then also they are very important. For example, you must have seen in the ad of salt that mere salt mein namak hai. What is that for? Iodine. Mere namak mein iodine hai. Iodine is a mineral and that is required by our body. If it is not there, then we may suffer from deficiency diseases that we study later on. The other minerals that are required by our body are iron, calcium, iodine and phosphorus. They are required by our body in very small quantity and they are called protective food, because if they are not having, we are not taking them in sufficient quantity, then our body may suffer from deficiency diseases. And the sources of minerals are cereals, green leafy vegetables, fruit, milk, cheese and curd are rich in minerals. Now, here is the picture of sources of mineral. That is kidney bean, milk, whole grain, green leafy vegetable spinach, broccoli, curd, paneer and cheese, meat, then lettuce, then dry fruits, whole grains and butter are the main sources of minerals. Now what is roughage? Roughage is the fibers present in the food items that we get from food items that we obtain from plants only, that is fruits, vegetables and grains. These are rich sources of roughage. Why do we need roughage in our body with our diet? Roughage play a important role because it helps remove undigested food from our body. That's why we are suggested to have salads along with the food that we are eating. Now water. Why water is required? Because water helps body to dissolve, digest and absorb the food. It helps in removing our body waste through the sweat and urine. That is why we are asked to drink minimum 6 to 8 glasses of water every day. And it helps remove waste products from our body through sweat and urine. Now, after going through all the constituents, you must have known that all the components of food are required and we should be including all the components in our daily diet in some or the other form. Here is a pyramid shown that shows that vegetables, milk products you should have and whole grains you should have in maximum quantity. For example, rice, chapati, bread, that you should have in maximum quantity. Then fruits and vegetables you should have. Then milk products. And for non-vegetarians, they can have milk, egg, meat, and fish in their diet. And oil, butter, sugar, cheese, all these are sources of fats that you should have in very less quantity in your diet. This way, you should have a balanced diet. Now, I would like every one of you to make a diet chart for you and it should be a healthy diet. What you should have for breakfast, for lunch and dinner. In that you have to make three columns for breakfast, lunch and dinner, and then you have to include in all the three meals all the healthy items you should have. And then you have to give me the source. If you are having milk, from milk what all you are getting? If you are having chapati, what is the component of food that you are getting from chapati? That way you have to make a chart for yourself. Right? This is your homework.